So I got some really neat stuff to show you this time around. I have an awesome What's Inside the Box. I even have, I went on a chase. I went and kind of chased a train. I tried it out one night. I will post a little video of that. It's not great, but it's something entertaining, so you can check that one out too. What else have I done lately? The house has come along. I'll post more videos of it. The drywall in my time right now is, the drywall is up. They will be mudding next week, and it's pretty much close to being done. I'm looking out here like, I can see, you guys can see what's going on. But I'll continue posting the house build videos so you kind of see what's going on. Granted, it's a few weeks behind, almost a month behind, but it doesn't hurt to post them. Well, I got something really amazing for What's Inside the Box, so let's go check it out. Every now and then there's like an amazing step in technology or whatever, from Intel, from Apple, and even in model railroads. We just had an amazing leap in N-Scale. It's unbelievable, and I have a feeling you guys have been seeing this stuff happening on YouTube and everything else, but I got my set. TrainWorks has released an amazing set of trucks. They're basically heroes and villains of trucks from famous TV shows and movies. So we'll start with a look at them. You got the classic tanker truck from Duel. We got Sonny Pruitt's truck from Moving On. Some of you guys might not be old enough to remember this stuff. BJ and the Bears truck right here. We also got the Snowman's truck from Smokey the Bandit. I did not get the Optimus Prime. I don't know. Maybe I should have, should not have. But this is just amazing. TrainWorks has done an amazing job. From what I understand, this is a one-man operation, and I hope he brings more of this stuff to us. So let's get started and have a real close look at these amazing trucks by TrainWorks.
The villain from Duel, the Peterbilt with the 33-foot tanker, Sonny Pruitt's Kenworth from Moving On, from BJ and the Bear, the Kenworth Aerodyne, followed up by the Kenworth from Smokey and the Bandit. All these trucks represent pure nostalgia from the kids growing up in the early 70s and 80s. It's kind of part of the CB generation. For you kids that don't understand that, Citizen Band Radio. 10-4, good buddy. Let's zoom on in for a closer look of these great models from TrainWorks. 1971 brought us Steven Spielberg's movie The Duel. The movie Duel brought us our first truck in this series. It's a brown tanker truck with an unseen driver that chased an individual down through the desert. It's actually a great copy and representation of that truck. It is missing a couple detail items, which the one that bugs me is it does not have the evaporative cooler out the back window. And I believe the chassis is a little bit longer than it should be. But other than that, it is a great copy, and if you lay this on your layout, people will recognize this truck immediately if they come from that time period. TrainWorks in-box detail lists this as model number 55195. It's a Peterbilt 280/351. According to the Duel Wiki and the Peterbilt Wiki, it is actually a 281. It has a 33-foot tanker on here, which I don't have displayed right now, so we can get a nice tight look at this truck. As I noted before, it is missing the evaporative cooler on the rear window of the cab. In the movie, that's where the camera actually sat for the in-shot views. I believe the chassis is a little bit longer than it should be, and it does not have the flip-up hood with engine detail as the other trucks do. It does have great underbody detail, and it's just an outstanding model. The only thing it's missing really is a driver figure, but you couldn't even see the driver in the movie. It'd be nice to have seen some sort of driver in there and maybe darker tinted windows. From 1974, we have Sonny Pruitt's Kenworth truck from Moving On. Moving On aired from 1974 to 1976, had a total of 46 episodes. Moving On stars Claude Akins as an old-time independent big rig truck driver, Sonny Pruitt, and Frank Converse as his college-educated co-driver, Will Chandler. The theme song, Moving On, was written and performed by Merle Haggard and was number one single on the Billboard Hot Country Single Charts in July of 1975. TrainWorks lists this model as 59097. This is just a great model of Sonny Pruitt's Kenworth. It's a W900 VIT with a 40-foot van on back. And it is just a very nice model and represents the truck as seen in the first season of Moving On. One of the neat added features for this model is the opening hood with great engine detail. We'll look a little bit closer in a few seconds, but it's just an outstanding feature to have an engine detail with an opening hood on a little model like this N-Scale Kenworth. It's been really nice to see a model of Sonny Pruitt and Will Chandler in the cab driving the truck versus an empty truck like this. I have not figured out how to open up the body to add two driver figures to the vehicle. Or if we weren't going to add driver figures, at least tint the windows a little bit so when you have it sitting on your highway, it doesn't look like a ghost truck. As with the other three models, this one requires just a little bit of adjustment, the level of cab, a few other things, trim off the little nubs on the wheels and that kind of stuff. But beyond that, this is a really fine model. I'm really glad they actually have a copy of this model. And just looking at the engine detail alone, it's like you just want to leave it sitting here parked with the hood opened up. But we want to put this thing on the road and get it moving on. 1978 brings us BJ and the Bear. Ran for four seasons from 1978 to 1981. An interesting side note is Claude Akins from Moving On is now the Sheriff Lobo, pretty much the arch nemesis of BJ McKay and the Bear. Just like the other trucks in this series by TrainWorks, you flip open the hood, or in this case, tilt the cab forward, and it has a highly detailed, for N-Scale, diesel engine. The Kenworth K100 Aerodyne, and it also has the 400-foot reefer of BJ and the Bear, is just an outstanding model. Like the other ones, it does have minor flaws and differences. It does not have an interior in the sleeper, and it's easily seen through the windows on top of the sleeper, which should be covered up, which will give it a more realistic appearance. The other things it would be nice to have is a driver figure in there, BJ McKay, and why not throw Bear in there too? As we zoom in closer to this Aerodyne, you can see that the lettering and everything's just crisp. You can read it if you have enough magnification on it. It's just an outstanding model. And if you pop open the hood again and lean this cab forward, you can look at that diesel engine underneath that cab. This model, like the others, is covered with all sorts of separately applied detail parts and metal etched parts. It's just an outstanding model. I cannot express how nice these models are and how small they really are. This is an N-Scale truck with superb detail. You can't get any better than this. This is a huge step forward. Like I said before, it does have minor details and fly issues that should be fixed. There's no sleeper interior, so you end up looking down those top windows. But those things can be fixed. TrainWorks has just set the bar on these models. 1977 brings us to that movie classic, Smokey and the Bandit. Remember that this wasn't about Burt Reynolds. He'd not get top billing. It was about Jackie Gleason. That's why it's Smokey and the Bandit. It also starred Sally Field as Carrie, Jerry Reed as Cletus, aka the Snowman, among others. I always think it's funny, they always go, it's about Bandit, but Smokey's first in the title. We owe that to Jackie Gleason. TrainWorks lists this model as 59094. It's a Kenworth W900 with the 40-foot reefer featuring the mural of the Stagecoach robbery. Just like all the trucks in the series, it would be nice to have figures within the cab, so when they're on your highways, on your layout, they'd have somebody driving them. It'd be nice to see Jerry Reed, aka Snowman, and Fred, the Basset Hound, as a passenger. This truck also features a tilt forward hood with a great diesel engine that is well detailed in it. Just looking at this, I can hear Eastbound and Down, the theme song to Smokey and the Bandit, sung by Jerry Reed. This is just a great model by Trainworks. It features lots of detail and separately applied parts. It does feature that tilt forward hood to show off that diesel engine underneath. That's a lot of detail for an item that you probably will not see most of the time. It does have a few minor flaws, little flashing and nubs on the tires. On the right rear of the truck, it has a little silver dab of paint that got outside of the rim, but it's all little adjustments and fit and finish on this very small model. You gotta realize how small this is. It's less than an inch wide.
If you're lucky enough to have gotten some of these trucks, when they came out, they ran for about $45-$50 bucks each. Now I've seen them upwards of $150 on eBay. I really wish Trainworks would have produced a lot more of these. Let them know. Call Trainworks up and tell them you'd like to see more trucks like this. Maybe even other vehicles like cars and automobiles. It's just an amazing product. I'd really like to see them follow up with some more trucks from other movies, like the Blue Mule from White Line Fever, the Pork Chop Express from Big Trouble in Little China, the Duck from Convoy, or even the Road Warrior truck from, obviously, the Road Warrior, the either before or after. I prefer the before would look more appropriate on the layout, but the after would be cool too. Maybe Trainworks might even look into producing automobiles. It's just amazing work. They sold out like crazy. It's one of those things to where it's hard to believe. I used to watch these movies as a kid, Moving On. When I was a little kid, I always wanted to be a truck driver. BJ and the Bear, all that kind of stuff. The Duel. So, call up Trainworks and let them know. Tell them thank you for this product. I'll post the phone number down below and links. Let them know that they produced an amazing product. Produce more of these. From what I understand, they're a limited edition. They released them really quick. Within 2 weeks, they were gone. So, either way, if you got some, they're awesome. If not, hope you enjoyed checking them out. And thanks for watching this little clip. This is something a little bit different for me here. On Facebook, somebody just said there's a Norfolk and Southern train running through town, and I've never actually gone for a train chase before, so I'm going to give it a try, see if we can catch it. I was told that the engineer knows somebody up here, so he might actually stop at a siding and let people have a look. So we'll go see if we can catch this train. I just got notified via Facebook that he's actually left Phoenix area. He has clearance down through this section, I understand, so we'll see if we can catch him and something different. So be back with you in a little bit. So right now we are heading down Baseline. We're heading east. We're coming up along the Union Pacific tracks. The first set of tracks is south through Chandler. We'll be crossing those up here in the middle, a few seconds here, as you can see the crossbuck up there on the right. And then right along there's the diagonal tracks that run at a 45 down through Gilbert, and that's where we're going to be heading. We're going to try catching that train down through here. I'm going to look and see if I can see any signals down here on the right. You can normally spot stuff. I really can't tell. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to zigzag along this diagonal here and we'll chase this. I'll make a left up here, or sorry, a right, and we'll rerun over the tracks again. We'll just keep doing this right-left movement. Get down to where the train should be and hopefully we'll catch something. So we're up here at McQueen. Make a right across the tracks again as these run 45, which is basically south
east-west through this, or southeast, I'm sorry, down through here. As you can see, here comes the same set of tracks again. Let's see if we can catch any signals or anything giving an indication if that train is moving or not. I don't see any signals lit, so we might be well ahead of that train. Well, we've crossed the tracks a couple times. We're just kind of zigzagging back and forth until we hit about Pecos and Power Road, which is southeast from here, and we will see what we'll see. Hopefully we'll... I think we're actually beating the train right now. I don't know, but we'll find out. Right now, we're just south of the diagonal. We're coming up on the tracks again. We're still at Elliott. We're running through Gilbert right now, so we're going to cross over the tracks again, heading to the east. I'll see if I can spot any signals down the track to give me a clue if anything is coming, other than the emails I've been receiving on Facebook. I don't see any lit signals, red or green, so if it's on its way, we're well ahead of that train. So we're pretty far down south. We're now around German Road, Germain, and we're heading towards Power. We're heading east along Germain, so we should come up along the tracks again pretty soon. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to actually turn the camera. I'm going to mount it here on this window and shoot it out the window mount. So if we catch up with the train, we'll just pace it down Rittenhouse Road and see what happens. It's actually kind of dark. It's not as moonlit night like it was the other day, so you might not see a damn thing, but who knows? It's worth a try. There's the headlight to the train. It's on its way. I'm gonna get on the other side of the track so I can chase it, but we're getting close. All right, we're down here at Sossaman and the tracks. I'm gonna turn back around, but I did spot the train. I can see the headlights as we run across the tracks. I'm gonna turn back around up here and I'll line the camera up so we can see if we can catch this train. But that's where we're at right now. It's kind of wild at nighttime when it's this dark out. You can spot the headlights for a train a mile away. So I'm gonna flip one right here at this stop sign. Swing back around the other direction. Get ready, because I can see the train, the headlight, which I'm pretty sure you guys can't pick up on the camera, but it's down there, so it should be fairly soon. So I guess we have a semi-successful intercept. I can see it, it's just not here yet. Well, that's the end of the line for our little adventure. It's long gone. I don't know how good the video will be on this. It was dark. Maybe we'll do it during the daytime. First try. So we'll go home and see how this video turned out, and we'll post it. Thanks for watching.
As a reminder, don't forget the YouTube Model Builders Big Build Contest. I will provide a link down below. Check it out. We're getting close, about midway through this project building and everything. I have about 8 or 9 people that have actually posted videos. I'd like to see more. If not, understand what to do. Go review some past videos. I'm like pointing down below here like you can see them. Look at some of the past videos on that and check it out. Post your videos. Enter. There are some great prizes. So go check out YouTube Model Builders and go check out the YouTube Model Builders Big Build Contest hosted by me. And start building some models. Hey, as always, thanks for watching the video. If you like them, give me a thumbs up. If you don't, give me a thumbs down. You know how it works. Subscribe below. And don't forget to check out my Facebook and my Twitter channels. And subscribe to them too. I will get another video out soon. And thanks for watching.